Spirit of the Lord is here. The atmosphere is changing now. For the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around that the Spirit of the Lord. Overflow in this place, fill our hearts with your love. Your love surrounds us. You're the reason we came to encounter your love. Your love surrounds us. Overflow in this place. Fill our hearts with your love surrounds us.
You're the reason
we came
to encounter
your love surrounds us.
We're surrounded by. Spirit of God, fall fresh on us. We need your presence. Your kingdom come, your will be done here as in heaven. Yeah.
Spirit of God.
you stand with us this morning?
Born unto us this day, a Savior. Gifted from heaven to a manger. The hope of the world, a light for all mankind. All of the earth rejoice, it's Christmas time. So lift up your voice and sing out his praise. Christmas, born as a king, rejoice in the day. It's Christmas, make a joyful sound. It's Christmas, let his praise resound. It's Christmas. Goodwill to all the earth and peace divine. Christmas time.
It's Christmas time.
So lift up your voice and sing out his praise. It's Christmas. Born is the King. Rejoice in the day. It's Christmas. Make a joyful sound. It's Christmas. Let his praise resound. It's Christmas.
Are you glad it's Christmas time? We can rejoice in the King today. Hallelujah.
Behold the star of Bethlehem, the Word of God has become flesh. Unto us a child is born, the Savior of this broken world. Oh, hear the angel voices sing, come, let us adore. Open hands, he rules with love on David's throne. All praise belongs to Christ alone. Oh, hear the angel's voice says, sing, come, let us adore. Come, for our King is with us.
Mm-hmm.
we adore thee.
Sing it again, holy.
Holy, holy, holy. Jesus, we adore thee.
Holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy. Jesus, we adore thee.
Holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy. Jesus, we adore thee.
One more time, holy Lord.
Holy, holy, holy. Jesus, we adore.
Adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Oh, hear the angels' voices sing, come, let us adore him. Peace has come, for our King is with us.
We sing, holy, holy, holy.
Jesus, we adore thee.
Holy, holy, rejoice in that this morning, that peace has come. Even in the midst of everything else that we've dealt with this year, peace has come to us because our King is with us, because God saw fit to send his Son to the earth. The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees. Oh, hear the angel's voices.
truly he taught us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace.
Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord. Oh, praise his name forever. His power and glory.
That's why we celebrate this time of year, is the birth of Jesus Christ, that night when he was born in Bethlehem. Hallelujah. I want us to go to the Lord in prayer this morning as we begin our service and just pray for those that are in need. We have so many within our church family that are hurting, struggling. We have so many within our community that are really struggling from this virus, and families that are losing loved ones, and it's a tough time of year right now for a lot of people. A lot of people are losing their jobs and all kinds of things going on. So let's just pray and just ask God to just touch each one of these that we know. Just pray for the ones that you know. As I pray for many others that we have, we all know, but maybe pray for somebody special that you know this morning that really needs some help from the Lord today. Heavenly Father, we just thank you that you are the Lord of all the universe. God, you are the God of all gods, the King of all kings. And Lord, we're so grateful that you were willing to come into this earth and become one of us, to live among us, to bring us back into relationship with our Heavenly Father, so that today we could come boldly before the throne of grace, before our Heavenly Father, and ask and petition on behalf of our friends, our family, our loved ones, God, our people in our community that are in such need. Lord, this world is in such need of you today. Oh God, there is such a decay of morality, such a decay in so many areas, Lord God, that that are bringing them farther and farther away from you. But Lord, we're asking you to come. Come once again in all of your power and all of your might and all of your glory, God, into this earth and touch each one. God, I'm asking you to touch families that are hurting right now because they've lost income. They've lost their jobs. They don't know what they're going to do. God, give them hope today in Jesus. Lord, I'm praying for those that have lost loved ones, Lord God, during this COVID time, or God, other things that have happened, God, during this year, Lord, where they've lost their loved one. God, I pray that you will surround them with the Holy Spirit like never before. Give them comfort and peace and joy, even in the midst of their trials. God, I'm asking you, God, to touch Larry Johnson, Lord, as he is in the hospital, God, and just pray that you would just strengthen his lungs, strengthen him completely, Lord God. Father, just heal his body, Lord, of this cancer. Lord, we pray. God, I'm asking you to touch Shirley Dirks and God, for Barbara Graham and God, for God, there's Renee Guiano, and Lord, there are so many others, Lord. There's a whole list that, Lord, that we have of people that are in need from this church body. God, I'm asking you to surround them with your presence and heal them and deliver them, as only you can do. Father, we thank you that you sent Jesus, and that he was a baby and he was born in a manger, but Lord, that he didn't stay there, that he went to the cross and he died for us so that we could be free. We could be free from our sin. We could be free from the guilt and the shame in our lives. Lord, we could be free from disease and all sickness in Jesus' name. And Lord, we just thank you for that. We praise you this morning for all that you have done for us and all that you continue to do for us. Now in Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You may be seated this morning. Hallelujah. So good to have each and every one of you with us today. We welcome you. If you haven't been to Grace Point before, we're glad that you're here this morning. You may have come for a kids' play, and that's awesome. We want you here, and these kids are going to do a great job here in just a few minutes. We're going to have them come up, and they're going to do the kids' play and everything. But I just have a few announcements that I want to make just as we get started today. Normally, we have Next Steps class right after services, and this is our class to help you to find out more about Grace Point, to find out more about our church and just how you can be a part. We would love to have you start this up. First Sunday in January is when we'll begin the Next Steps classes again. And it's right after service, and we provide a meal for you. And we would love to have you come and join us for that class to find out more about Grace Point. I want to remind you about the gifts that we are collecting for the three different school systems. We have three different teachers that we're collecting gifts for their students, and they're due today. So if you haven't brought them in, please get them in to us either sometime this afternoon, maybe drop them by, or come by tomorrow and drop them in to us. But we need to get those as soon as possible. Unfortunately, the school systems have shut down, and so it's going to be a little bit difficult for us to get them to them before Christmas, but we will get them their presents, okay, and make sure that they know that they are loved and blessed by Grace Point. And so we just want you to get those in as soon as possible to us. Last week, we introduced our winter small groups, winter semester small groups. I encourage you, go online and sign up. These are our groups that we put together to help bring discipleship into your life. That means to bring growth in Christ. That's what that's all about. Amen? Jesus told us to go and make disciples, right? He didn't say go and make converts. He said go and make disciples. Disciples are people that study about Christ. They study the Word. They study to find out more about Jesus and to live more and more like Him every day. And so that's what these small groups are all about. So please go online, sign up for a small group, at least one. Some of them are going to be in person. Some of them are going to be on Zoom. Because of just the life that we're living right now, that's how we have to do it. And so we encourage you to go and sign up for those. Next week, I want you all to hear this. Next week, we will start at 11 o'clock. Woo! All right, there's one. I knew I'd get some applause. Way to go, man.
11 o'clock next week, so you get to sleep in a little bit. We are going to have a communion service. It's going to be a service where we're going to read scripture. We're going to sing songs. We're going to have a time of communion together and just remembering what Christ has done for us. So it'll be from 11 to 12, be a shorter service, but we want you to come and be a part of that if at all possible. If you can't be here, join in on Facebook. We'll have it Facebook Live, but we want you to be here if at all possible. All right, and then I did want to announce also that, you know, normally on New Year's Eve we've had a family game night. We're not going to do that this year. Obvious reasons around that, but we just wanted to encourage you to spend time with your family during the holidays. Take time and spend with your immediate family or maybe some of your close friends and just spend that time with them and enjoy your time together. That's what this season is all about, is spending time with each other, amen, and remembering what Christ has done for us. All right, well, those are our announcements this morning, and what we're going to do is I'm going to introduce Pastor Madeline, our children's pastor, and she is going to come and introduce our kids' play to you this morning. Let's give her a hand as she comes this morning.
Hello. So there, announcement showed last week about the small group. There was a small group that got left out. And I promised I would mention it this morning. It's for our young ladies, we mean elementary ladies. And they do, they've been doing a Bible study on the women in the Bible, and which was led by Miss Pat Storman and Cindy Swope. And so they do all sorts of creative crafts and bring the Bible to life through there. And they meet back here behind the sanctuary. So make sure that you look for that. It'll be on the list. Just didn't make it in the video, so I wanted to make sure that they knew that they were loved, and we are excited that we have something really cool for our girls to do on Wednesday nights. And that being said, this has been a really challenging year. Has it been challenging for anyone? Has anyone had to learn how to do anything new this year? We all have had to do new things, and so this Christmas play is called A Socially Distanced Christmas. And so it's all about a children's pastor who is having to scramble to get a Christmas play together for people who can't be in the same building together. So so we're going to present that to you. I just wanted to say also for those who are watching online, I spoke to someone earlier this week. It was a lady that goes to our church who I've never seen in person before. And so we had a good conversation, and so I wanted to encourage you to reach out if you are there, because there are ways that we can connect. We can even have lunch online together or do any kind of way. So if you are feeling lonely during this season, please make sure to reach out to us, because we are here. We want to connect you. We want to reach you, and we want to celebrate the Savior's birth with you as well. All right, so if all of my actors and actresses forgot that you were supposed to be moving into place while I was making announcements. Let them get in place. And I would just like to present to you A Socially Distant Christmas.
Lucy, this is Miss Rittenhouse.
Oh, hi, Miss Rittenhouse. What can I do for you?
You can start by explaining to me why on earth you chose to cancel this year's Christmas pageant.
Canceled?
I understand that because of COVID-19, you have chosen to cancel the performance.
No, Miss Rittenhouse, I think you know better than to listen to.
I may remind you that you agreed to put on a Christmas pageant every year.
And I intend to.
This church has had a Christmas pageant every year since my great-grandfather found it.
And we will have one this year, just that, well, it'll be a little different.
How different?
Well, for starters, instead of it being in person, it'll be online.
Online?
Yes, Miss Rittenhouse.
How on earth is that going to work?
Well, instead of having a choir of kids bunched together on a stage, we'll have a choir of kids bunched together on a screen.
You mean like one of those Zoom meetings the young people are always talking about?
Yes.
And will they be singing real carols?
Yes, they will. Mostly.
Mostly?
We're living in extraordinary times, Miss Rittenhouse, and that calls for something extraordinary. Okay, kids, is everyone ready?
Sidewalks, dressed in holiday style, not a single shopper to be found. They're all home now, they're online now, shopping Amazon Prime, and in all public spaces you're here. Face mask on, face mask on, it's a social event. It's Christmas. Ding-a-ding. Zoom meeting. Oh, what a strange Christmas day. There's a turkey, but no dressing. They were out at the store. Instacart sent us ramen instead. All the presents, sets and ribbons, outside your hair. Face mask on.
Face mask on.
Face mask on.
Face mask on.
It's a socially distant Christmas. Ding a ding. Zoom meeting. Oh, what a strange Christmas day.
Ready for your big scene?
I sure am.
Wow, that's a great costume.
It is?
Yes, it looks just like the prophet Isaiah. Your costume is amazing.
Oh, this isn't a costume, it's my bathrobe.
It is?
Yeah, see, I'm still in my pajamas too.
But it looks so dirty. Looks like you've been living in the wilderness.
Well, it's been a while since I washed it.
Like how long?
Let's see, today's Tuesday. I want to say it was April.
April?
What do you expect? I've been living in quarantine since March. Haven't worn real pants since Easter.
Oh, my.
So how do we do the scene anyway?
I'll press record and you'll speak into the camera like you're addressing the people of ancient Israel.
Yeah, about that, Lucy. This is a Christmas pageant. Why am I reading from the book of Isaiah?
Because Isaiah was one of the prophets who told people about Jesus long before he was even born.
For real?
Yes.
Wow.
You ready for me to begin?
Let's do this.
We're rolling. Go for it.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. And those living in a land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Perfect.
Cool. Thanks for letting me be in the pageant this year.
Do you want to know how you can thank me?
How?
By washing that robe. It's disgusting.
Go tell it on the mountain, over there. that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching, or silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens, there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. The shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angel chorus that hailed our Savior's birth. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Down in a lowly manger, our humble Christ was born. And God sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. That Jesus Christ is born. That Jesus Christ is born.
Hi, Maddie. Hi, Rachel.
What's up?
Hi, Maddie. Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Alicia.
What's up?
Are you two ready for your big scene?
Ready when you are.
How about you, Rachel?
No, I'm not. I'm not sure I can do this.
Why not?
Lucia, I'm a stage actress. I've never done a film before, especially like this.
Oh, boy.
You're going to be just fine. Just listen for your cues and say your lines.
Say my lines? Actors don't just say their lines. I need to know who this woman is. I need to know what a Venetian doll.
You're married. You were called to be the mother of Jesus, and you said yes.
But why do I say yes? What's my motivation to say yes?
Obedience to God, faith. Mary was a woman who loved God, and despite all the challenges she would face, she gladly accepted God's call. Make sense?
Yes, yes it does.
All right.
But what's the motivation before the angel appears?
I don't know. She's cleaning house?
But why is she cleaning?
The floors are dirty?
How dirty?
Yes. Rachel!
Okay, I'll make it on my own.
Thank you. Maddie?
Hang on, I'm almost done with my game.
Game?
I got bored of you guys fun and decided to play some games.
Maddie?
Fine, okay, I'm back. Let's do this.
Rachel, are you ready?
Ready.
Action.
I want to say to all that. If I choose to, then I would get out. My own family may even reject me. Yes, even my beloved Joseph. But do I dare disobey the call of God?
Rachel.
No, I cannot say no to Matt because I must not be afraid. I must be faithful. I must be.
Just say the line, Rachel.
I'm the as you have said.
Wow, that was great.
Really?
It'll do, Rachel. Thanks, you guys.
And thanks you, Lucy, for believing in me, for believing to reach out and do a film.
Oh, brother.
About this baby boy who's come to earth to bring us joy, and I just want to sing this song to you. It goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift. With every breath I'm singing,
expecting child, they searched the end to find a place, for you were coming soon. And there was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only Son was born. Oh, by night to see this baby wrapped in light. The angels led them all to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in a manger bed. Emmanuel and Savior, hallelujah, hallelujah.
rescue me. This baby boy will grow to be a man and one day die for me and you. My sins would drive the nails in you. That rugged cross was my cross too. Till every breath you drew was
going.
Okay, I guess.
You all set for Christmas?
Yeah, but it sure doesn't feel like Christmas. We usually do all our shopping in stores, but this year we had to do it all online.
I know what you mean. I always enjoyed the crazy crowds at the mall. It's not the same when you just sit and click on Amazon.
It's not the same when your grandma can't come to visit either.
No, it's not. But think how that first Christmas was for your character. He had to pack up his pregnant wife and travel many miles to Bethlehem just because the emperor wanted to do a census.
And there was no room to be had.
See? It could be worse.
So where's the innkeeper?
He should be on in a minute. Said he was still working.
He's still working? Isn't he a travel agent?
Yes, he is.
Is anyone actually traveling these days? I thought the whole world was still on lockdown.
He says they're doing very well. Oh, look, there's Jared now.
Am I fashionably late?
Well, hello there, Jared. How are things?
Just peachy, Lucy. I just booked another happy family on a Disney cruise in 2023.
2023? 3 years from now?
Well, you know, the ships aren't sailing right now, are they? You're a paradise travel. You can book now before the post-COVID cruises fill up.
Oh, brother.
Are we ready to go?
Ready when you are.
Just a second. Jared, are you still wearing your name tag?
What? How did that thing get on my costume? It sort of fits the theme, me being a travel agent and all, doesn't it?
Take it off, Jared.
Okay.
Okay, boys, take it from the top.
Excuse me, sir. My wife and I have traveled very far, and we need a place to stay.
I'm sorry, but we have no rooms available.
Please, my wife is pregnant. She may give birth to our child this very night.
Listen, I'm terribly sorry, okay, but we have no rooms to spare.
Nothing at all?
Perhaps next time you'll book ahead. Might I recommend Paradise Travel Agency?
Jared
Whitman and his friendly staff are there Monday through Friday to help with all your traveling needs.
Jared.
Whether business or pleasure, the good folks at Paradise Travel.
Jared!
What?
This is not a free commercial. This is the Christmas pageant. Just do your line.
Fine.
Take it back from Luke's last line.
Nothing at all.
I can see you're really in need. I have a stable out back. It's not much, but there's a room and some soft hay where your wife can lay down.
Thank you, sir. I really appreciate this.
It is my pleasure. Sorry I can't do more.
You've done more than enough. More than you will ever know.
Nicely done, boys. Great job.
Thanks, Lucy.
You know, I always found it strange that Joseph couldn't get a room in Bethlehem. As a travel agent, I wonder how many rooms were even available in the town, especially with so many people there. The Son of God certainly deserved better.
I think it all worked out exactly the way God wanted to. Imagine how different the nativity would look with Jesus in a proper crib in a palace. How much easier is it for us to remember baby Jesus in a manger in a stable?
I see what you're saying, Lucy. It wasn't about his comfort, it was about ours. Jesus humbled himself so that we wouldn't be afraid to come and see him for ourselves. That's a sight more wonderful than a Hawaiian sunset, and trust me, I know.
No crib for a bed. The little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the
Well, hello there, shepherds. How is everyone doing?
Hi, Lucy. It's nice seeing you in church.
Oh, I miss you guys, too. And look, you all match.
We decided to coordinate.
That's right. My idea to go bathrobe to towel. Don't we look great?
I'm sorry, Steve. What was that?
I said it was my idea to go with the bathrobe to towel.
Steve, your mic's not on.
Turn on your mic, Steve.
How did I do that?
Steve, turn on your mic.
How did I do that?
It's the little icon on the bottom of your screen that looks like a microphone.
I don't see an icon.
Steve, turn your mic on.
I'm trying.
Turn on your mic. Do you think he can hear us?
I don't know. I don't think he can.
I don't think he can hear us.
Steve, I got you a Lecrae CD for Christmas.
And I got you a Star Wars hoodie.
He can hear you guys just fine.
What was that?
I said he can hear you.
You got me Lecrae and a Star Wars hoodie? You guys are the best.
Angels, hi. Perfect timing. Don't look at how stunned my shepherds look.
Wow, they truly look frightened, all except Steve.
Steve, look frightened.
Okay.
Quick, angels, say the line.
Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people.
Until born
this day, in the city of David, a Savior who is Christ the Lord.
You will find a babe
wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
Great job. Now, shepherds, who's got the reply?
I was just kidding, Steve, about the Christmas gift.
Me too, Steve. We were just messing around.
Guys, you're lying.
Let us go to Bethlehem to see this thing the Lord has made known to us.
Now, someone besides Steve, since he can't turn on his mic.
Let us go to Bethlehem and see the thing that the Lord has made known to us.
Beautiful. Just beautiful.
A star shines bright so long ago, as shepherds kneel, their hearts aglow, and from afar the wise men know, follow the star, the path to show. First Christmas light, Christmas light, you're bringing hope, so light up the night. Christmas light, keep shining bright, you're pointing to the King, so shine with all your might. Christmas light. Now you and I, we're like the star. Let's light the way, both near and far. For those in need, we must shine bright. For in our hearts, we hold the light. Christmas light, Christmas light, light. Bringing hope, so light of the night. Shine with all your might, Christmas light. Darkness spreads when lights grow dim, and we forget to shine for Him. Christmas light. Shine with all your might, Christmas light, keep shining bright. All throughout the year, gotta let our light shine bright. Christmas light, Christmas light. Christmas light, shining bright.
too.
Wow. Look at you guys. You look amazing.
What, this old thing?
Where did you get those?
Monica went to the custom depot and found and had one of these leftovers from the fall season.
Is that the one that was in the old Bilo?
No, that was Custom Village. Custom Depot was an old Sears store.
Was that at the old Toys R Us?
No, that was Custom Emporium.
It's not hard to keep track.
Well, you both look terrific. I can't wait to see what Jake is wearing. Hey, Jake, great costume.
Thank you. Aaron and Ron wanted to coordinate, so they told me to wrap a gift and birthday paper, get a crown from Burger King, and just wear a... Guys, why are you all wearing the fancy king costumes? They were selling at the costume states in the old Rite Aid.
I'm sorry, dude. I really am.
You look good, man. I love the crown.
Oh, brother.
I can't believe it. They got me again.
Again?
Last year over the Zoom Easter program, they told me all the disciples were wearing Jedi robes.
We all log in our bathrobes, and here comes Simon Peter looking like Obi-Wan Kenobi.
At least I didn't have to spend money this time. Well, other than the $3.99 I spent on my Whopper so I could get my crown.
Just go with it, Jake. You boys ready for your big scene?
Ready? While we've traveled for many days and nights to the east to come to this land.
Hey, Ron, your line? We come to find
the newborn king.
We saw his star in the east.
We saw his star in the east, and we gave him gifts.
We went to the palace of Herod, but he was not there.
We traveled through the streets of the royal family, but he was not there.
We walked through the fancy neighborhood, and he was not there.
We found him in the arms of the wife of a poor carpenter. The Messiah had come.
We bowed down and worshiped him. We thanked God for allowing us to see his face.
We offered him gifts fit for a king.
Gold,
frankincense,
and myrrh.
You sure those are not Legos? Those look like Legos.
Boys.
Sorry, Lucy.
But the greatest gift of all, the child who received our gift.
God sent his son to be our savior.
Because God gave us Jesus, we can also receive the gift of eternal life.
That's a wrap. Good job, boys.
Yeah.
Miss Rittenhouse. How are you?
Lucy, I just saw the practice of your so-called social distance Christmas pageant.
It's okay. I'll clean out my office and we'll be out of here by noon.
I love it.
What?
Lucy, what you did was incredible, to pull together all those people online and tell the story of Jesus. You did a wonderful job.
Why, thank you.
I must admit, I didn't think it was possible. I expected you to fall flat on your face.
I can't say that I blame you.
But in a strange way, your little Zoom pageant told the Christmas story perfectly. I know it wasn't easy for you, but how easy was it for Mary or Joseph or those wise men who traveled so far?
I know.
Riding on camels with no air conditioning and worse, no Pandora.
That's true.
You showed the true meaning of Christmas. The Christmas story, God sent his son into a troubled world in troubled times. And if we believe in him, well, you know the rest.
We know that Jesus can be our Savior and receive eternal life. We'll end it with another socially distanced Christmas. Hit it, kids. this month.